Hello aviators, and welcome to the new topic which is called as areas in the airport. Now this is a very important topic. This is going to be like the foundation of your training for the ground staff, and what it explains is the areas where you would be working on a daily basis. Okay, since this is a course which is job oriented, it is particularly related to where you will be working on a daily basis. So according to that, we have the areas which are there in the airport and where you will be working. So to start with, this is an overview of the airport, how it looks. Okay, and first we'll start with the land side. Now land side of the airport means from where the passengers get dropped down from the cabs or the taxis, okay, or their vehicles, and then they enter the airport. Okay, that is called as the land side. The other side, which is where the parking of the aircrafts or the takeoff and landing happens, and where the various other operations takes place inside the airport, okay, is called as the air side. Okay. Next, the building where the passengers do all the formalities, maybe it is security, then it is check-in, then where the passengers wait for their flights. And there are offices of the airlines and various other operations. The whole building, the whole airport building, is called as terminal building. Okay. Next, we'll come to the bridge, which is called as Aero Bridge. Now, Aero Bridge is something that connects the terminal building to the aircraft. In simple words, this is a bridge which, after the aircraft comes and the engines are shut off and it is parked, then the passengers come through this bridge and then they enter the aircraft, which is called as embarkation. Okay, so this is called as Aero Bridge. Now in case if the aircraft is parked away from the terminal building, very far away, they use something called as step ladders, and the step ladder will be placed, it is just like a ladder. Okay, and then the passengers will be taken in a coach or a bus, and then it comes and it brings the passengers to the aircraft, and then they enter the aircraft. But for bigger aircrafts, or where there are almost like 500 passengers to board, or it is a full flight, and on a daily base it is a very international flight or a heavy domestic flight, so most of the times they use Aero Bridge for the boarding and deplaning. Okay. Next is called as ramp area or the parking bay. Now, ramp area or the parking bay is the most important area where you as a ground staff would be working, because most of the times when the aircraft is parked, you have 30 minutes of time to complete your procedures. Say it could be monitoring the cleaning staff, it could be giving the documents or preparing the documents for the flight for takeoff, and then helping the cabin crew, helping the pilots for refueling or catering, various other things. We will cover up the duties of where you would be working on a particular day and what your duties would be in the following topics. But for today, just remember these areas. Next is called as apron. Here in the bottom, as you can see, apron. Apron is a defined or a dedicated area, which is also a safe zone. Now, if you may see in this image, here the aircraft is parked, and imagine the aircraft comes this way and it takes a turn and it gets parked and the engines get shut down. Until the time the aircraft comes and gets parked and the engines are shut down, there will be there is a defined area which is marked in this way, that who have to get prepared for the next flight. Say if this flight has come from Hyderabad to Delhi, and now it is in Delhi and it has to go back to Delhi to Bombay, so you have a very quick turnaround time. You have hardly 30 minutes of time, so within 30 minutes you have to prepare this aircraft for the next flight. So what it happens is, the staff, the ground staff and the engineering staff and the refueling truck, the catering staff, everybody, they bring their trucks or the equipments and they keep it over here, which is a safe zone, and then they, as soon as the engines are shut down, the pilot gives a okay thumbs up to the other staff that they can enter the aircraft and they can start their procedures. So basically it is a safe zone area where everything is kept, and as soon as the pilot gives a thumbs up, they start their work. All right, so now as you can see here, I have given these 8 points and what they mean. So you can just pause the video and write it down, okay, in your notes. Yes, so the first one, starting with the land sign, which is the entrance of the airport. Then you have the air side, complete area where takeoff, landing and aircrafts are parked, and then terminal building, as I've explained you. Then aero bridge, a bridge which connects from the terminal building to aircraft, parking bay, apron, then taxiway and runway. These two things I'll just explain you. If you can pause the video, please note it down. Then we'll come to runway and taxiway. Now say this was the terminal building, the aircraft is ready and it is moving for the departure. Now, slowly it has to come and it has to wait until the other planes take off or landing is going on. The runway is an active area where takeoff and landing goes on. Okay, so the taxiway is the path which is connected to the runway and to the parking bay or to the ramp area, or you can say, okay, so here is the parking bay. As you can see, this is the parking bay. So the aircrafts are ready, now they are coming, they have to take a turn, and once they take a turn, they come to the runway. So taxiway is the connecting path to the parking bay to runway, and runway is something where aircraft takes off and lands. Okay, so simple as that, very simple to remember. You can just note down these points. Okay, so, and furthermore, in the next topic I'll tell you where your duties are going to be, where you would be working on a daily basis, and how your job role is going to be. So as for an example, you won't be working in one defined area on a daily basis. They will decide where you will be working. Your manager or your superior staff would be deciding that you would be working near the security, or you would be working near the counters, you would be working near the ramp area. So according to your experience, it differentiates where you would be working. So in the next following topics, we'll cover up those things. Okay, so thank you very much. Please note down these topics. This is very important. Thank you.